Today I'm going to make the smallest programmable circuit I have done so far, using an Attiny 85 microchip in a QFN20 package, which is going to be quite difficult to solder, and it's the first time that I'm going to release something so small. But let's try. This is a circuit I'm doing out of curiosity, and also because it's a challenge to solder something so small. As I said, I'm using the Attiny 85 with a fairly small surface mount package. The main idea of this circuit is going to be to flash an LED light that we're going to program with Arduino IDE. The flashing of the light can be a sequence of Morse code, like SOS, or you can program any other type of sequence. That is the main idea, but since the microcontroller is capable of performing any other task, it can be programmed to be connected to some external sensors and respond to any external triggers. It's very similar to what we could do with the Joychip. The Joychip is something we did in a previous video. They have the same microcontroller, only different package. The exciting thing about this matter is that this circuit is quite small, and I'll use conventional soldering techniques, using a soldering iron and tin, instead of using solder paste and stencils, so it'll be fun and interesting. During the design process of the PCB, I had to modify the footprint where the solder goes and the microchip aligns to. This is in order to facilitate the soldering process with my soldering iron. The only thing I did was to extend the pads out a little, to have much more space to work with, to be able to move the solder in that surface. After completing the design, it's time to send the PCB board for production. If you wonder what software I'm using, it's a software called EasyEDA, which is free and works pretty good. This software also belongs to JLC PCB, which is a sponsor of this video. To order the board is really simple. We simply export the driver file, or you can also order directly from EasyEDA. Select the parameters that you want your board to have, and that's it. If you order 5 boards, you pay only $2 plus shipping, which is an excellent price. And I have a little gift for you. If you already have an account created on JLC PCB, you can go to the link in the description of the video and enter your details, especially the name of your account, so that you can receive a coupon that you can use in your next order. This is only for the first 5 people to enter. Well, after waiting for 3 days, I received my boards. And as always, they look good and in excellent condition. Now we have to get to work. As you see, this board is not complicated in its number of components. On one side, I will only solder the chip, and in the other, the LED light, resistors, and a MOSFET. The key to soldering this chip successfully will be the alignment and enough patience. I will use a soldering iron with a fine tip, but you can use any other type of tip, because what matters is the amount of solder that we're going to place there. Only a bit is enough, and then move it through all the pads. It is also important to use a good quality solder, and also flux, that will make our life easier. I made 2 of these small circuits. In this first one, I was trying to see the best way to solder the chip, and what I recommend is to solder one side first to hold the chip in position and well aligned, and then proceed to the rest of the sides. I also recommend to only use a small amount of solder. If you use more, it doesn't matter because you can extract it using one of these tools or any other technique. The important thing is that the contacts of the chip remain soldered with the pads. The flux makes it easy to move the tin and heat it up because after heating it for a long time, the flux begins to dry. Flux transfers the heat efficiently and causes the solder to melt evenly. Let's take a look at the soldering process of this chip. In summary, it is to align the chip as good as possible and start applying the solder on one side at a time. Of course, that sounds easy, but for the small size of this component, you gotta have enough patience and a good steady hand. To record these images, I had to put the camera in a rather awkward position and complicating this process even more. The central part of the chip at the bottom should also go soldered to ground, but it was quite complicated because the solder made the chip rise. I know I should have put a hole, but it connected with the LED on the other side. But there are already other pads connected to ground, so I hope it's not so critical. Once the soldering process is finished, we have the chip ready. Now what we must do is to program it through our Arduino IDE. If we can burn the bootloader without any problem and upload a program, it means that the chip was soldered successfully. Otherwise, you will have to do a very close inspection to find the problem. Now I solder the rest of the components to operate the LED light. The last thing I do is to solder some pin headers to connect a battery. This is a single cell LiPo battery and is used in some small radio controlled aircraft or micro drones, and has a maximum voltage when it's fully charged of 4.2 volts, and it can discharge up to 3.2 volts. So it is within the range accepted by the microcontroller. There is also a micro battery I was using in a previous project that seems perfect for this project due to its size. So I took it out of the previous project, which was a bicycle light, and I put it to use with the circuit to see how small the circuit can be. The circuit is ready now, and also the challenge, because we have managed to solder this chip without any major problem, and it's fully functional, but we are going to test it. I will place it in one of my radio control airplanes, and as you can see, it is quite visible at great distances. This glider is flying at distances of up to 300 meters or 1000 feet, and it's still possible to see the flash of light. As I mentioned earlier, this chip can be programmed to do other tasks, such as handling a servo among other things, exactly the same as the Joy chip. But here you can see the difference between the size of both chips. I can say that this project was a success. I should also thank other YouTube channels in which they teach how to solder small components. Thanks to them, I have learned how to do this type of soldering. I'll leave the links in the description of these videos. For now, I hope you liked this video, and I'll see you in the next project.